Oh, also infrared light has no longer wavelengths and lower energy. The visible light cannot be seen with the human eye. With the human eye. They only said eye. So they're only saying eye, but two eyes work together for this eye. Really. This is the first eye where the infrared light gets received in, so you can see through these two. Anyways, we're gonna get deeper into that. But mosquitoes, vampire bats, bed bugs, and some snakes and beetle species, however, can use portions of infrared spectrum for visions. Sometimes humans can see infrared. Sometimes humans could see. I'm gonna say C as gamma. Sometimes human can gamma infrared energy in the form of heat. Moving on. Alright, so boom, the pit viper. Pit vipers are animals that are known best to be able to see infrared light. The pit in their name comes from the special pit organ that rests above the snake nose. You ever notice the snake doesn't use its two eyes to see? It doesn't use its nose to smell. Really, all this shit is kind of like in reverse, but you can also use your tongue to smell. Just like the elements, like how all of them deal with plasma, and how water actually deals with fire, and how true water deals with fire. And all the other elements. All the four elements really come together for that one element. But they also deal with plasma from the sun above, right? And you might say the moon too, because the moon is the backside of the sun. So, being moon new energy, which is land, is attached to some lands that's below. Right, like the land of Mu, the land of Nu. Everything above is attached to something below. We live on the Garden of Eden, to be honest. And the tree of life, its roots, is still on Kai. You never break that. And you being having the same DNA in the universe, that means it's in you. You're the atoms outside of you, inside of you. Your atoms are cells. Your cells, memory. Remember. Make it make sense for yourself. I'm trying to make some shit make sense for myself while hoping you make some sense for yourself. But me, I be sound crazy as hell. But I be right though. So it's like, I gotta keep fucking with it. It's like, pit viper. Boom. Pit vipers are the animals that are best known to be able to see infrared light. The pit in their name comes from a special pit organ that rests above the snake's nose. So, I was trying to do this shit. I went left and found some new information, so I'm restarting this video. So, dang, actually, I don't want to do that. Alright. I'm gonna pull. How did y'all go? Yeah, but they definitely know when to celebrate it. They do not want to go use the bathroom. Alright. Boom. Actually, let's do that. Hit Oregon. You see that? Everybody's trying to use my microphone. Pit Oregon. I don't think I need to be using this app anymore. But, alright. The ability to sense infrared thermal radiation involves independently in two different groups. Oh, the pit organ acts as a directional distance receptor and makes it possible for the reptile to strike at warm prey. A rattlesnake pit organ are located between its eyes and nostril. Vipers, pythons, and boars have holes on their face called pit organs, which contains a membrane that can detect infrared radiation from warm bodies up to 1 meter away. At night, pit organs also the pit organ allows snakes to see an image of their predator or prey, as infrared camera does, giving them a unique extra sense, third eye, right? Remember, some people, they might be tied into that, but a lot of symbolism was used with the Kundalini or rising, or you tapping into that, right? As symbolism of animals, not saying you were that animal, it was symbolism, right? Because we have certain attributes of these animals. So me, I have a certain attribute of a pit organ, I mean, or other, I mean, we all do, but I'm saying that because I seen through a fucking wall in infrared, and it came from a fucking gamma. The laser hit me though, right? The laser hit me. So boom. And when I felt like a predator was coming for me, I saw through darkness, through the wall, and saw my homie's girlfriend put the key inside the door, twist it open. Come in, turn the light on, and it disappeared. It was 2017. An X flare hit, right? The magnetics field was up, right? Infrared, UV, ultraviolet, high intensity light came from the sun to weaken. Really, it wasn't just the sun, it was the suns. Feel me? Came weaken the magnetics field. Boom. It came through. So when that happened, they got scared, right? They got very scared, right? Very, very, very scared. Right? So And I was trying to figure out what the fuck that meant. And I figured out what it meant. Around last year. Around this time. And figured out why. Look through the wall. And then it's just, I love how like everyone is tapping in, is getting downloads. Like me, I'm tapping in, but I don't really have too many like subscribers and shit right now at the moment, but it's gonna get there so it can spread. But I also have to do my part, because really I was getting hella shit and just didn't know if I should or not, or what to do. And really, I don't know, I was just trying to rush it too much. But it was a self thing for me, because I had to see what was happening to me. Because things that I had writing down, dreaming, seeing, speaking, feeling, I was seeing it. And it was speaking through someone else. That's why I feel like
I fucking was shouting him off. He said he felt like Ezekiel.
You feel like Ezekiel, I feel like Enoch. So we gonna keep this shit rolling. Is that what happened to Enoch, or what Bobby Hemmett said? I wish I could find that video, because you're the only person that explained what the fuck happened to me. And he said I can't be touched by the Nomicons because of what happened. Can't be touched. It's like garlic around the neck from a vampire, keeping away a vampire. Alright, so look. Let's get back to it. Viper pythons and boas have holes in their face called pit organs, which contain a membrane that can detect infrared radiation from warm bodies up to 1 meter away. At night, pit organs allow to see an image of their predator or prey as an infrared camera does, giving them unique extra sense. Yes. Both groups of snakes employ the services of special sensory structures called heat pits, which in pythons and boas resemble holes located in the upper and sometimes lower labial scales, essentially upper and lower lips, of which there may be up to 13 pairs present. It's like how you have 12 strains plus spine. So your memory is in your spine. Especially your solar memory. Because that's why they have to kill your red blood cells. And when it first starts to begin, it starts in your solar plexus, which is your spleen. Okay, that's why you don't need no signals of pathological blood destruction, in other words called lysis, because that fucks with your solar plexus. Alright, so which your solar plexus is part of your cycle. And above cycle, so it's like it fucks with other things, other chakras. Feel me? Fucks with your spiritual connection. And the only thing that can bring you back to it is your heart. The energy gravitates to the Merkaba. So, you harness a lot of it in the root. It's just like water in the pot when it rises. Alright, so, shit, where am I going with this? Where is the pit organ located in the snake? Infrared IR receptors, one located on each side of the face, roughly midway between the nostril and the eye. Snakes have reverse set of rods and cones. I was just saying that. The specialized cells in the retina that the animal uses to detect light, having multiple types of visual pigments inside of the cones, allow the animals to see in color because their pigments are sensitive to different wavelengths of light. So despite having poor eyesight, they can see through glass by detecting infrared rays emitting from your body unless the glass of the cage blocks infrared rays, which is not very likely. Also, it can detect movements. If you are moving outside the enclosure, they can still sense you. What is the membrane called? That's what I want to see. It sounds like the third eye. Pit receptor. What is this about? We present a theoretical study of interaction of low-density lipoprotein receptors with coated pits. From published experiment, we estimate the forward rate constant K or kappa for the binding of LDL receptor to a coated pit on a human fibroblast at 37 degrees Celsius. In the meantime, an LDL receptor spends on the cell surface before being captured by coated pit. If the LDL receptors enters, it remains within the coated pit until the coated pit pinches off a form of a coatal vesicle. The K plus equals 3 times 10. Oh shit. Pieces and shit. No. Oh, that's wild. That has something to do with, the square root of the sun. It has something to do with the square root of the sun. And the down, the, that has something to do with the square root of the sun, bro. And something to do with the black cube of Saturn. Fuck. Alright. I gotta do something, too. Fuck. Give me 1 second. I'll be right back. Because this value is agreement with the experimental determined value for D, which stands for delta. Delta stands for UV, ultraviolet. We conclude that random insertion of LDL receptors into the plasma membrane, followed by per-diffusional motion of LDL receptors on the cell surface until they are irreversibly absorbed in a coated pit, is consistent with the experiment. Delta also represents increased increment. Right. So boom. On the surface of human fibroblasts, receptors for low-density lipid proteins are constantly being removed and replaced. These 1 through 8. These process internalization of LDL receptors and insertions of LDL receptors into the plasma membrane occur even in the absence of LDL. The rate of internalization, whereas the rate of insertion, is strongly affected by the presence. After LDL receptors is inserted into the plasma membrane, it apparently moves in the plane of the membrane until it's trapped in a coated pit. The receptor is internalized when the coated pit pinches off to form a coated vesicle. Whether the LDL receptor inserted in random positions over entire cell surface or at selected sites. In this paper, we use published data to estimate the forward rate constant and mean capture time for trapping the LDL receptor in coated pits on human fibroblasts. We then show that the values of these parameters are approximately equal to their diffusion limits, the values they would have if LDL receptors were inserted randomly into the plasma membrane and then move purely by diffusion until they encountered a coated pit and were trapped where they just said the same shit over and over. These we define as concentration to be average numbers of receptor per cell. The concentration LDL receptors in the coated pit on the cell surface increases when LDL receptors collide with and are trapped in a coated pit, and decreases when coated pits evaginate and pinch off to form a coated vesicle. All right, so the D, I say, yeah, represents delta. That's dealing with X-rays in the lab, or you're dealing with X-rays coming from the sun. But D also has a medical term. So, and that's heterolysis. So they try to use that for your Z. So really they use the Z for your delta energy, but the Z, the D is for the Z, for your Zen, right? Because the whole part of putting receptors in you, you already have natural receptors, like your ears is one, all your senses are receptors, your melanin, your sodium channels. That's like your cells are receptors too. They're receptors to your thoughts and emotions, right? So like, and to the shit you eat. So that being said, they're trying to cut your Zen off. But we're going to get back on this shit in a little bit. I'm going to come back. I got to do something real quick.